Amazing. This is my 7th Fright Fest in 8 years. It was gutting to have to miss last year, but we were in production on my TV series, so I couldn't be here. A moment into walking in, and it feels like I never left. But this is my favorite festival in the world. I've been to all of them at this point, and there's nothing else like Fright Fest. Well, the difference with Fright Fest is that there's lots of festivals all over the world that celebrate the genre. But at Fright Fest, I can say from a filmmaker perspective, you get to come and you do this, and you get up and you introduce your movie, but then you get to be a fan like everybody else. And you go and you sit in the audience with the fans and discuss the movies with the fans, and you're treated like a normal person. And some of the other ones, they keep you so separated from the fans, and you only have like a select moment to sign, and here you're just treated like a fellow fan. I mean, I've always considered myself a Fright Fester, and that's, I think, why I keep coming back. I can tell you with Hatchet 3, for all the places it's played, this is the only one that I'm going to with it. So it was very important for me, because Hatchet 1, I feel like it was born at Fright Fest. As much as it had screened at Tribeca before, this was the first horror festival it played at, and then it blew up and became this huge thing. So Hatchet 2 had its world premiere here, and for Hatchet 3, for the ending, it was very important that I be here for the end. So. Well, if you think about the three of them as one long movie, this is the big action climax. So this one has even more kills than the second one, which I don't know how we did that, but we did. Lots of explosions, lots of fire, lots of great cameos that people don't even know about yet. We purposely never published the real cast list just so people wouldn't know who to expect to see in it. So a lot of real big surprises there, and kind of an emotional last 5 minutes. I came up with Victor Crowley when I was 8 at summer camp, and really just as a story to scare the other kids. And I think that that's why he works. I think it's very simple. It's just like your average campfire ghost story. But he's also a very sympathetic character, in that he wasn't a bad person. He didn't ask for this. Even the fact that he's still mourning the death of his father, and night after night he's forced to return and wanders the swamp crying for his father. You have to have a touch of sympathy for your villain, or else you don't have a villain. And I think that's why the greatest of all time is always going to be Frankenstein's monster, because he didn't ask for this, and he doesn't know what he's doing, and he's just, scared. And I think in that way, I think that's why people identify with Victor Crowley. Digging Up the Marrow, which is my next movie, it started as a documentary about monsters and interviewing artists and filmmakers and makeup effects people about where the ideas come from. And I've always wanted monsters to be real, and my whole life I've prayed that I would really see one. For some people it's ghosts or aliens, but for me it was monsters. And somebody wrote me this letter saying that they could prove that monsters were real, and the idea came about of, well, why don't we start interviewing? And it sort of blossomed from there. So I don't want to say too much about it, because I don't know really how to describe it. It's not really a documentary, and it's not a found footage movie, but it's, it'll be interesting to see what's real and what's not, but it's what I've been calling now a manipumentary, because it's a manipulated documentary, where I got to sort of live out my ultimate fantasy and make things come true. So I think if you love monsters, and if you've ever wished they were real, then I think you'll really enjoy watching this. Well, to everybody waiting for Hatchet 3, thank you for making this come true. The fact that we got to make all three, the fact that we got to outdo each one, all because of the fan support, there's not many people in my position who get to do that. I mean, we literally get to make these movies only for the Hatchet fans, and that's because there's so many of them, and they actually support the movies. They don't BitTorrent them. They don't steal them online. And that's why we've gotten to keep going, and that's why the movies have consistently gotten better. A lot of other times, you're forced to broaden it out, and they tell you, well, you have to bring in a wider audience. You have to tone it down. We've always gotten to make these movies exactly the way the fans want them, and that's because the fans supported them. So I owe you guys everything.